So my next question is from Rob in the USA. Rob asks, what kind of drill is best to use, corded or cordless? The great drill debate. So I've chosen a cordless drill. In hindsight, I should have got a cordless drill with a whole bunch more batteries. The reason being is that on a busy day, you can run your batteries out relatively fast, and you now got to go and ask your customer, please, can you just charge batteries for you? As opposed to carrying around an extension cable, I think it's the lesser of two evils. What's important to remember, though, is that your drill should not be overheating. So choose a drill that's going to give you, be able to perform for long periods of time without overheating. Make sure your drill has a 10 mil chuck, because the rotator shaft, which connects to the flex shaft, is 10 millimeter. That's very important. And if you're going to go cordless, make sure you get extra batteries. I would suggest that anything from 800 watt upwards is going to be fine. Another thing to take into consideration is that your drill should have variable speed and a slip chuck. The next question I have is from Jonathan in the UK. Jonathan asks, what is the sleeve bearing all about? So Jonathan, the sleeve bearings has two functions. The first function is to prevent friction on the edge of the flex shaft sleeve. The flex shaft sleeve will wear out quite quickly if the flex shaft is rotating in that sleeve, but seems to be only at the end. And for this reason, we put a bearing on it. It keeps the flex shaft center at the ends. But the biggest and most important reason for a flex shaft sleeve bearing is to prevent dirt from getting in between the sleeve and the shaft. When you have dirt there, it does affect its performance. So I hope that helps. The next question I have is from Alexander in Poland. Can I just use a PVC pipe instead of buying a sleeve? No. There's nothing stopping you, but I don't recommend it. The reason being is that we actually have the sleeve made for us, and we have to buy kilometers at a time. The sleeve itself has a chemical resistance to it. It has a specific type of flexibility and rigidity, specifically for the flex shaft. And the other thing is that it has a heat resistance that is important. And if you use a PVC pipe, which is meant for irrigation or carrying water, you're more than likely going to find yourself melting that. So I don't recommend it. I have a question from Tyrone in South Africa. Tyrone asks, what is the difference between a circular chain and the other chains? Okay, so a circular chain is used for descaling, whilst the other chains are used for removing obstructions. Having said that, I do know that clients are using the circular chain for removing obstructions as well. Some of them are just basically putting the chain further back on the shaft and adding a drill head to the front of it. What's important to bear in mind is that your circular chains have got two specific types. The one is without hard metal bits, and the other is with hard metal bits. And the difference between these is that the one without the hard metal bits is meant for PVC, whilst the one with hard metal bits is meant for cast iron. Your regular chains also come with the hard metal bits or without the hard metal bits, and again, for PVC or for cast iron pipes. Now, some of them have got a drill head on the front and others not. You can choose basically what you'd like to do, but what you'd like to buy, but these are mainly for removing blockages, almost like a liquidizer, blending up blockages, obliterating them. So I hope that answers your question, Tyrone. If you have any more questions, feel free, just send them to me. So my next question is from Theo in Canada. How do I cut my flex shaft if I've kinked it near the end? Okay. So Theo, no matter how good your flex shaft is, there is a possibility you can kink it. And if you kink your flex shaft, you basically put it inside of a vise, use a nice angle grind, nice clean angle grinder blade, and just slice it straight off. Don't use a hacksaw. And if you want to try and avoid kinking your shaft in the first place, you might want to make sure that the space that is between the flex shaft bearing and the actual power drill is as small as possible. Don't have a large space between the drill and the bearing, because that gives the opportunity for the shaft to kink should it bite into something and the slip chuck doesn't catch up in time. I have another question from Liam in Israel. What is the optimal working speed? Okay, so Liam, the optimal working speed is between 1,500 and 3,500 RPM. Having said that, I think it's important to bear in mind that slow and steady wins the race versus fast and furious. At the end of the day, it's not so much about the speed, it's about the quality of the chains. And if your chain is a good chain with slower speed, you can achieve the same thing. So the other advantage to going slower is that you stand less chance of kinking your shaft should your shaft bite into something. And that's why I would prefer to go with lower revs than higher revs. So my next question is from Nicholas in Argentina. Nicholas asks, is it possible to purchase a different size flex shaft to the ones that are available on your website? Okay, Nicholas, I presume you mean the length of a shaft, and if that's the case, yes. We have 6, 8, 10, and 12 millimeter shafts, but we can get it to you in any length that you like. So if you want a specific length which isn't available on the website, then we'd have to cut it for you and deliver it to you, which means that I couldn't possibly get it to you in the 3 days, 4 days that I can if I deliver what's in our depot ready for delivery. We put the most standard sizes into the depot so that those are the most popular sizes and people will you know, usually order that. But if you're looking for something specific, I can definitely make it for you and send it to you. My next question is from Mike in Australia. Mike asks if we deliver to Australia. And the answer to that is definitely. After America and the UK, Australia is our third biggest consumer. We aim to get these tools to pretty much every country in the world. The reason for this is because these tools are really good for countries that have limited access to water. And we think that if you don't have the water resource to pour down 500 liters per minute to clean a sewer, then this is a very good alternative. And that is our number one goal. So getting to Australia is really not a problem at all. So my next question is from Terence in the United States. Terence asks, what tax will I pay? So Terence, the HTS code for these items is 8207.90. Now an HTS code is basically what tells customs what sort of tax rate that they should charge on these items. So far it seems that it's around 2-2.5%. It varies from country to country, so please make sure before you order. Some countries I've noticed, they don't charge taxes at all under a certain amount. So it really varies. The second tax that you'd pay is your normal value added tax. But technically, this is a tax that you deduct at the end of the month anyway. So it's not really something that, you know, you pay it and then you claim it. So that's the two types of taxes that are involved. The next question I have is from Daniel in Ireland. Daniel asks, where is your company located? So Daniel, the administration of our company is located in South Africa. The workshop is located in Finland and the logistics is located in another part of Finland. The sales and management is located in Serbia and Montenegro, depending on what time of the year it is. And it's a digital world. You know, we have the capacity to do this. So why not? That's how we roll. So my next question is from Ian in the United Kingdom. Ian asks, is it possible to just place my order with you by email or with WhatsApp? Because I don't have time to fuss with the website. No problem, Ian. Just send us an email. Give us an idea of what it is that you're using, what it is that you're cleaning. Is it PVC or is it cast iron? What is the average dimension of the pipe, the diameter of the pipe? Whether you're dealing with commercial clients or domestic clients, municipal clients. And then, of course, we'll send you a proposal. If the proposal is suitable to you, you can just let us know and we'll send you a Paygate link and you can check out pretty much like you would do on the website.